Good afternoon and welcome to Blindbuilds. I'm your host, Blind Prime, and for today we will be continuing on with the cave building project. Kream the cat here is loving on my arm, and for today we're going to be doing part 5. Part 4 was what I called the grate and the frog, which was a bunch of frogs and a big old grate, and they kind of cave chunky. I like it. I hope you enjoyed it too. There's been a lot of attention in part 3, which was where I did the overall build, and it took a while. I didn't think that would actually get that much attention because those videos were so long. But apparently, you know, it did get that much attention. That was really cool. So, you know, thanks to people sharing. So today, we're going to talk about toppers. Today's video will be 2 toppers for part 5. We're currently in the process of building 1, and we have already built the green topper. This is the green topper, and it's what I decided to just call a blank green space, because, you know, they don't really have many of these in Lego. You know, there's never really just a nice green space to do things with. I'm going to throw a couple of trees on top of it. I mean, I've got a couple down here right now, so we can just grab, you know, that little tree there, and, no, not that, not that. A little push, but no, we don't need a push. Where's that other tree? I had another tree in here. Oh, there it is. So there's that tree. Now we just need a little cool tree. Where's the cool tree at? Green, do you know where the cool tree's at? No. I can't give all my notes. Oh, I found a cool tree. I lost it. Green, I lost it. What is it? There. Okay, so we got some trees. He's a loving guy. Okay, we're going to slide those pieces because I put them off to the side. I believe they're all green and they're going to be important for this build. Let's see, we got some trees here. We can go ahead and pull them. There's just a couple of trees on the corner. And there's just a little bit of forest scene going on over here. Come on, Mr. Tree. Mr. Tree. Oh, don't go so far. Yeah, a couple of trees, and a little tree. Okay, little tree, come on. There it goes. That's too far. Little tree, get closer. Get closer. Okay. And we'll scoop this tree back just a smidge, I see. Okay, there we go. There. Nice little tree scene. Anyway, I figured having a green plate that's just blank would give people who may want to do something with this set in the future have something to build upon and have their own little creations. Maybe put a picnic table there, maybe a little forest scene, a little garden. But it's for the person who gets the set to do with what they will. So that was the topper. And of course for the topper I have the same scheme of connections that I had before for the house, which means that so where my right finger's pointing is where the Technic pin would go, and that's on the far right hand side with me. Actually, the side that's facing me, it's on the far left hand side. So you would put it there and then just go clockwise around the edge and put it adjacent so that no corner has two of these Technic pieces on it. So there won't be a Technic piece on one side, and then, you know, you turn the corner and there's another Technic. It should just be on the edges every other corner. Anyway, we'll work over here, and let's get this kind of build going. So I've already kind of started it, and I've got a bit of green going on there because this is supposed to be a pond. So I took a big old 16 by 16 blue plate that I had no idea what I was going to do with, and I put it down here. And I'm building upon it now. So I've got these little bushes, or at least little leaf things, and I took one of the underwater seaweed things and put it sideways to act as kind of roots or something that's stretching out into the waterway there. I've also put a slanted brick on the other side to kind of give the impression of a, you know, a slope to this pond, and then over here, because you know it is mountain terrain, we've got a little cave. And pull up the lid of this real quick, because we do have to do a little build inside of it. I wasn't quite done building it, I just wanted to check and check your sizes. But inside of this little cave, we've got an eroded away area, maybe a little cave area. Put a fun gem in there, just on the inside. And I've got to build up this part here to add a little stability. Actually, I don't think I need to. Maybe just be a little lazy and leave that part just empty. Because it's not really going to be seen much, and it's going to more apply towards a cave-like structure. So the other side, I've set it up so that this can just sit by itself as a little mountain, you know, a little cropping that comes out, or you can actually shove it up against something else. And what do you do? Don't break anything. No, he's moving on somewhere. If you take down my leg, please don't take down my leg. Anyway, over here is, I put it, built some flat area so that if you want to shove it up against the mountainside, you can, and now that slanted area will be a bit of a cracked zone, or this will be kind of a by itself little stone area. I even went so far as to put a crack in the side and the edge that's just flat on the side of this panel, so you can just turn it around and do with it what you want. I went ahead and designed it so that it can look great in many different places. I'll go ahead and these two things need edge. Really annoying. I don't always like to properly snap into place. Just a little weird. I think it's because they're so thin. I don't think they should. If I had a piece that was the same height as those but four long, I would have used it. Trying to think about piece count with these toppers, and considering how things can be reduced. What's going on? I'm not exactly playing with the whole thing. What's going on over here? You're not clicking into place, and you're causing everything to screw up. Don't do that. Oh, it's that piece down there in the center. And I did for the fun little crack in the wall. Come on, crack in the wall piece. You're gonna have to peel it up. I understand why they use plates and stuff to kind of finish these things out, because getting a bunch of bricks to work under one plate is a bit of a pain. And you just gotta start it at the right angle and then bring it down. And there it goes. Didn't expect it to snap in place, but hey, you know, snapping in place is good. I mean, it's solid now. We got a little overhang going on, and now we have a little rocky outcrop. That's beside this little pond, and I have an even little area where the water can escape from the side of the pond. So if any other structures were to be built with a pond and, you know, with water in mind, you know, here's a source. Nice little cave, or little mountaintop spring head. So let's finish up this build. Not really much more to go on, that's why I decided to do this one. I've just got all these pieces over here, which I believe are the correct colors. And for this, we're going to just kind of get an impression of land, or at least green grass. I want this to look nice. So I've gotten as many green plates as I can. I'm just kind of trying to pick the right ones. So we can bring this down here, and that piece can help assist with stability. Maybe we have the correct size. You could be it. Yeah, I think you're it. Yeah, you're great. Set you right there on the side. Perfect. Now we can come over here and we can get not that piece, but we can use that piece in the future. Same with this guy. We've got that. Let's see. Okay. We could put that across, but I'd want to use these pieces somewhere else in this build too. I actually don't have that many green plates, so we gotta use them sparingly. We gotta be careful on how we use our green plates here as well. And that means that we got to get creative. And that's kind of one of the better parts of this stuff. So if I grab that 2x4 plate that I was thinking about using, where are you at, Mr. 2x4 plate? I just had you. And then I attached you to your friend. Alright, there you are. I'll set that 2x4 green plate there. And I'm going to set this edged piece here. And I think that looks nice. And we got that little spot there. With that little spot there can be taken care of with, where are they at? Oh, yeah. Actually, yeah, that would work. No, just a little too far. One by one there. Where is, I know I had a tapered piece. There he is, here he is, Mr. Tapered Piece. Now let's see if we can find us some flowers, and honestly, looking at that again, in here, I don't know what I did with my Lego piece, topper, you know, Lego tool. Oh, that's just an entire 2x2. And we just get rid of that. Yeah, we can just get rid of that. Instead, we'll put this tapered piece there. The very corner of it. And let's see what we can find to make that look nice. Got my box of greens here, and I know I have, there's a cool flower in here I just found recently. That's a useful piece. Out. We can use that in some of the type build on here. I have no idea what that is about. I'm just not using it. Not that. So you look kind of cool. Let's see. Oh, there's the other trees. They clung together. They had formed their own clique over here. Let's see. You know, when it's that piece problem where you keep stumbling across a piece and then you realize, hey, I could probably use that in this one exact situation. And then you can never find that piece again. Aha, no, you're another bush. Got some bushes in here. I may just use a bush there. That would be kind of neat, but that's too wide to actually utilize in that situation. Kream, do you mind? Kream, hi. Yeah? What, you want me to spend? You know what? I'll use that. I haven't used one of these before. We'll use it. Alright. There we go. Okay. We've got this fun little like, elephant ear thing going on there. We can set it on top of the cone. And actually, we can use that cone for something else. Where is the cone? The cylinder. Here's that cylinder. Put the cone off. That cylinder. There we go. Cylinder's making it look nice. You know, these weird plants are cool. They have these little spade leaves and three of them that stretch out, but whatever they made it out of makes the connection point really terrible. They like to just randomly pop off on them. You have no idea when it's going to happen. So I'm going to go ahead and put that cone right between them. Yeah, make it look nice. Okay, so that's that complete side done. We've got this corner over here with the cool cave and the crystal inside of it. So let's spin her about and let's work on another complicated thing. It just falls over sometimes. It doesn't like to stick. There you go. You keep doing that, I'm gonna have to trade you out for another plant. All right, so let's work on the difficult corner, which I consider this one to be the difficult one. We've got the edge of this rock formation. So I wanna try and get a gray piece going on there. Maybe. Actually, maybe something brown. Let's see. We got our browns and our tans that can make it here. And we could probably use something brown. Maybe take that, but I don't even have that. Let's see. We've got. I think the first piece I found will be the best piece. No. Too wide. That's going to totally be a useful piece if it's in brown, or even if it's in sand color, or up here. And we can set it off to the side. And we can grab something small. I just need something small. Come on. Too wide. digging down to the deep screens now. That's gonna have to work. Best piece so far. Set that back down. Find it as soon as I pick up the box. I should have done that in the first place. Alright, so we've got a 2x1, 2x3, 4x5, 6x7, 8, 2x8. And we can set that 2x8 plate directly across from this little slanted cliff face happening in the rock formation there. Squeeze that guy down, and now we can come over here and finish that corner out with some nice greens. Yeah, we got some greens going on here. Is that going to be a green? That green is too big of a green. But if we tilt some sideways and have them all across the edge there, it'll be a perfect color. Come on, hey now. Are you even a Lego? Are you playing tricks on me? Are you a Mega Block? No. You're not a Mega Block. You're not playing tricks on me. Okay. You're just an older Lego piece. There you go. Yeah. Alright. Now, we've got that little bit of an area right there we gotta take care of. And I just used one of those green one by ones to handle that. And I think I'm going to do the same again. Those guys, which are totally going to be used in a second, add a little flavor to this build, and we've got this cool plant that we could possibly use, this slanted piece, which I'm not even sure is green, and not many options here at all. I knew I had more green one by ones. I knew what happened. It must have rolled off. Kream, did you do something with my green one by one plates? Huh? Did you screw with them? No? You claim innocence? Let's see. Well, shucks. I thought I had them set aside. Oh well, we'll have to make do with something else. We'll have to find something else. Okay, this one is an easy one to find. I'm going to go directly down to the bottom here. Feel around and come up with a 1x2. Perfect. Boom. Perfectly placed. That's all we needed is a 1x2 to fill in that spot. So now we can come over here and get these greens going on. I'm going to finish the layer of stuff around this pond. Okay, cool. So we've got this piece right here, and over here on that side. This little human going. Hey, what's going on? Why aren't you pressing? There we go. That's better. Alright, so we need to fill in that little bit of a gap, and we also need to kind of blend things a bit better. So we could fill in the gap with this round green, but I don't think that would work there. So instead, we're going to fill in that gap with a... I wish I knew what color you were. I'm just going to throw that in the box. You got no idea what color. It's going in the unmatched box. All right. I've got a piece that could fit there, but I don't really want to use a piece like that. Instead, let's see if we can find maybe a dirt piece or a sand piece. That seems to be like a little bit of a up and coming piece, you know? Which aren't really going to work for us. So put that piece over there with that. And we're just gonna cover it up. Unless I can find a piece of this. And we've got this piece. It's three. Almost papers. So we could actually Yeah, and you know what? That works with this rounded slope piece there to kind of just be a... The ground is unstable in that part. Look at that. Worked out very well. And you just keep looking, and you'll find the piece that works best for you. That's right. Okay. Now, let's have a little fun with these green pieces and stack some stuff, right? Stack right there on this end. No, it's not good to have those two pieces stacked on top of each other. So we'll stack that on this side there. Nice. It's going to level that out. And we've got a... Not you. We can't do that piece there. You are going to have to... Oh, you took that with you. You're not supposed to take that one with you. That one just stays there. Thank you. Now you are going to go across. There you go. That looks nice. Yeah. No, no. Stop it. Okay. Stop it. Thank you. Hey. Hey. All right. There we go. And where's our other long piece? And I had two of them. There it is. I don't think you were the same sizes. You weren't, which was perfect, so you can actually stretch down. There we go. Get an impression of grass falling away on that side. Come over here to this side, and we can put in this simple elbow there. Hey, stay. It's a bad elbow. How are you guys doing this? I think I got all that measured out right. So you shouldn't be giving me problems. Such a weird piece. Oh shoot. Is it supposed to be higher up? No. Seems like I gotta put another piece under this guy in order to level him out. I think I'm holding a piece right now. But that's not going to be the right piece, is it? Hold on. Maybe it will. I can just peel. Nah, we'll just set it on top. Make a little sandwich. There'll be a gap between these two pieces. It's going to break. Okay, so come over there. That's better. That was what was causing all the problems. This guy wasn't properly supported. I have found this weird archway piece that was apparently used on a car or something. And so it comes up from this angled bottom, and it does a kind of a half arch, but then it tapers back down a bit. And that's what was confusing me on its height. So apparently it raises up a full brick worth of height from where it started. It's a really unique archway, and I've been trying to find a way to use it. And now that I've done it like that, there's a little cave you can put your pinky in. And you can do things like take little Lego snakes and slide them in there. I think that would look cool. If I find any Lego snakes, I'm totally going to slide them in there and make them part of the build when I turn this into Lego Ideas. I think that would just be a great place to have a snake hanging out. Remind people, be careful about little caves that you find. Right. And once again, this little plant piece fell off. You got totally dead by a plant. Alright, let's finish the build up on this side. We've got this piece here, which I'm not sure, once again, if it's the right color, but it is the right size, I think. What's going on here? You're not the right size, because you need to be two. And you came over there and did that, huh? And this came there. What fell off? There was something there. Let's see. No, not you. Oh, right, you. You fell off, because I put you there. But that was putting too much of an angle. And that was actually harming the project, so I couldn't keep you there. And tension went ahead and took care of the problem for me, which was nice of tension to do, but we still need to put something there, don't we? Let's see. We've got... let's see. What are you using here? That's not going to work. Okay. No, You know, let's use that round piece here. Round piece in there. Like that. Perfect. Now, we can find this piece here, this little crazy little plant with the leaves hanging off the side. Usually it's like bamboo or something. Okay, we can set that right in the middle. Right there. I think that would look nice. Okay. And set that piece there. Actually, crazy little tapered piece. How about you come over here and live? And you can live as part of this. And then you can go on top. There we go. I'll replace it with a flower once I get at my flowers. Okay, we're almost done here with this little build. I thought about doing a pier, but I think I'm just going to keep it more natural. Maybe let others decide if they want a pier or not. And, what is that? Okay, yeah, that's just a bit. We can actually take this little slanted piece and do a very precarious ledge. It's a ledge that will fall down. Meh. No, we won't do a precarious ledge there. We'll just leave it blank. I think that this is a great little addition to the cave, and we are totally done with this weird floppy plant. Let's see if we can find another one, and I hope I don't just run out of time. We can find another plant for this cave. We need another plant, Barnett. We need another plant. We can do that. I needed another plant for that other stuff too. Can't use that. That one's just not the right size. Oh, for a second it was. Oh, found one. Found one. Okay. Now we just need another one. So, one plant successfully discovered. And, you know what? It'll work for both sections. Okay, so we've got this little plant discovered that has a little lily. Plant lily thing. We can actually put that in the corner, and since it's round and it's a quarter of a circle, it actually will fill in the rest of that corner. Look how nice that did. That's perfect. That looks cool. Okay, so we're going to come over to, where do we put it? Here it is. Here's that bit. I'm going to get rid of you, Mr. Bamboo, but we can keep that bottom. And slide this little piece in there. There we go. Now we got some pink flowers. Isn't that nice? Yeah, I think that's really wonderful. Thank you. Oh, I knocked the tree over. We're just knocking things over here at Blindbuilds all the time. There it is. There's my zapper. Anyway, thank you. Oh, so much for joining me and Kream today as we build our two toppers. And for a reference, before I knocked over the rest of the trees, there we go. We'll put one of the trees back. Here we go. Hey, get out. Get out of those pieces. You're not needed anymore. Okay. Get Kream. No. I won't. Okay. Here we go. There's a reference. Look at that. The green grass is going to come over here. It may be a different shade of green, but isn't the green around the pond a different shade anyway? And then we can flip it over if we wanted to put it like that. That's nice. A little flower bush there. We can spin it around and put it in a different direction with the little rock face, so there's a little cave entrance there that kind of just looks like some thing. Show up that, yeah. And you spin it around one more time, and then you have where just the water can state goes underground at that point, like the Santa Fe River here in Florida. It just goes underground at a certain point. But that's a little comparison of these two guys. I think they look great together, and I am happy to say we're done with the toppers with the log cabin and these two pieces. So tune in next time. We're going to cover another middle section. Till then, thanks for watching.